Arrow functions in TypeScript are a little tricky, so we will first understand this and then implement it in our demo. Arrow functions are basically anonymous functions, also called lambdas in other programming languages. These anonymous functions have a very simple syntax. It might look a bit tricky in the beginning, but here it is. We use such anonymous functions to pass it as arguments to other functions. The general syntax of an arrow function is the parameter on the left, followed by an arrow. This arrow is made up of equal to sign with the greater than symbol. Okay, so the arrow is followed by the function body. Parameters, arrow, and then the function body. Let me show you a few examples. This is a single line arrow function. Here, I have declared a variable named it double it. This is the parameter with the type annotation inside the parenthesis. You can add as many parameters as you want. This works like normal function parameters. Then there is this entire function on the right side of the arrow. I have just used the parameter x and multiplied it by 2. This is a very basic example of arrow function with a single line of code. The arrow functions like this with single line of body have implicit return statement. The result of x multiplied by 2 will be returned from the arrow function. And we can now call this function by using the name of the variable to which the function is assigned, followed by a pair of parentheses and a parameter. Here, the number type. Now checking out a little more complex example. In case of multiple line arrow function, we use the curly braces. And here, we also have multiple parameters. Inside the body of the function, I have defined another variable z here, and then added an explicit return statement in which I have added the three variables like this. And then in the same way, call the function using the variable to which the function is assigned with two parameters. So this way, we can define the arrow functions with single line body, with multiple line body, with single parameter or multiple parameters. Now there are cases when we declare a function with no parameter. In such cases, just add empty parentheses like normal functions without parameter. And to use this arrow function, we will just call the function with empty parentheses. So this was about arrow function. Now that you have got a basic idea about the arrow functions, let us see the code in action in the editor. Let's convert a traditional function to arrow function. Here in my main.ts file, at the end of the file, I have added a simple function named logMessage. It takes a string parameter and returns nothing, hence the return type void. This has a log statement which just simply logs the string parameter. Now we will convert this function to an arrow function. Arrow function, as we know, are anonymous and do not use the keyword function. So I'll remove this function keyword from here. And instead of using this log message as the function name, I'll define it as the variable. Now for the arrow function, we need to add the arrow. So after this return type void, I'll add the arrow here. Type annotation are normally not used with arrow functions. So we can also remove this return type from here. Now since this is a single line of code, to make it simpler, we can also remove this curly braces and move this line of code into the single line. So now we successfully converted a traditional function to an arrow function. This is just a demo to use arrow function. Generally, the traditional functions are much more convenient to read and use in most of the cases. However, the arrow functions are mostly used when we need to pass an anonymous function to another function. This happens a lot in TypeScript and JavaScript codes. So now let me call this arrow function using the variable logMessage and pass a string to it. So I've called the logMessage function and passed this parameter to it. Moving to the browser, opening the Chrome Developer Tool. In the console, we have got our log message. Welcome to test your math. So this was all about arrow functions. Now, like we have defined this function here, we can even use it as a type. Let us see how.